Hi friends, I am back with another review. I got some fun Marvel Legends and had some fun playing with them. So I'm going to show you guys my unbeatable Squirrel Girl figure today and the set that she came with. And then I'll talk about some of the photographs that I took, what's great about her, some things that maybe aren't so great about her. But this is one that I've had a lot of fun with so far, so I hope you guys enjoy my review. First off, before I get started, I was going to share my Unbeatable Squirrel Girl run of comics from the 2015 run and realized as I was going through my things that those comics were actually lost in the great movers who stole four boxes of my comics war of 2018. So those comics are gone to me forever. But I do highly recommend that if you are not familiar with the Unbeatable Squirrel Girl, that you check out that run from 2015 when they brought her back. She was originally introduced in 91, I think. And she's just such a fun character, you guys. You know, everybody has sort of some serious elements to their origins and some serious background, and there's so many serious characters. Unbeatable Squirrel Girl is, first of all, really badass, but second of all, just a ton of fun too. So I highly recommend you check out that run from 2015. I wish I could show them to you. I had every cover, but that's just the way it shakes out. So with that being said, let's move on and just get right to the figure. So the Unbeatable Squirrel Girl set is not an exclusive. You should be able to find it anywhere you find Marvel Legends toys, and it retails for $39.99. It comes with Doreen. That is her name. If you guys don't know, Doreen Green. It comes with Doreen, an awesome scooter, which is her preferred mode of transportation, and a little Ooga horn for her scooter, and three little squirrel buddies. Her squirrels that are her two main companions are a boy named Monkey Joe. I think this is probably Monkey Joe, and a girl named Tippy Toe. So these are like her two main sidekicks that you see in the books. And then there's just like an additional says she does have the power to communicate with squirrels. So she can like, that's one of her abilities is like call hordes of squirrels to like come on and attack on her behalf. So let's talk about Doreen herself. I really love the way this figure looks, you guys. So the tail is a little out of scale from what it should be. So she is a young woman. I think that in the most recent series, they introduce her as about a college freshman. So she's young. She's 5 feet tall. She's very small and slight, and I think they capture that really well. But her tail is actually 6 feet long. So the scale of her tail is really scaled down with this, and I sort of get why they would do that, but what bothers me is that it really impedes posing her and especially sitting her on her scooter. That's one of the many things that makes it difficult to sit her on her scooter. So I feel like if they weren't going to make a concerted effort to make the tail work with the other accessories, that they should have made it to scale. That's my personal opinion. It should have been as big as it was supposed to be if it was not going to work with the accessories anyway. So that is persnickety. I know that that's a very picky thing to say, but I really like this character, and her huge tail is sort of a part of everything that she does. She can wrap it around herself, wrap it around others. It's really important to her super agility that she has. And this is very cute. It gets the idea across, but because it makes it difficult already to sit on the scooter and actually sit up, I figured they should have just made it right or made it actually out of like fur, which would have been really cool. Why not do that? So that bothered me. Other than that, I like her, you know, her face is great. This is what she looks like. They did not give her buck teeth, which is a little bit annoying, but she does have her little acorn earrings. Her buck teeth are actually a part of her special ability too. So she can gnaw through wood. She's got there's like a strength in her jaw that you know, she can use to for all kinds of situations, like whatever you would need to really bite through something. So it kind of stinks that she doesn't have the buck teeth, but her face is really pretty and she's got her little headband. So I like that. I love the color they chose for her hair. Sometimes they do it a little bit more animated in orange, so I thought this looked great. She's got her utility belt, which has her very unfortunately named nut sacks attached to it. And she's got her fur-lined boots, which are great. So as you can see already, the articulation in her ankles is great. It's really a little bit loose, but that's fine. I'm okay with that. I was disappointed in the movement in her arms. She doesn't have a great deal of movement in her arms, particularly in her elbows. So I found it really difficult also when I was posing her, when I was doing shots. But I think overall, if you guys look at the shots on my Facebook page, I think that once I sort of like worked it out, it took a lot more doing, but once I worked it out, she photographs really well. So I was happy with the way that it turned out overall. And I'll be sharing those photos on my YouTube channel as well. So if you guys aren't on my Facebook, you can see them there. So overall, I'm happy with her. There are logistical problems though. So she has little peg holes to ride on her scooter. But the problem is that her arms aren't long enough then when she's sitting to actually reach the handlebars. So she doesn't have a really good bend in her waist. Sorry, I need to hold her up so you can see. So in order for her to actually reach the handlebars, you sort of have to like sit her up. You guys can see what the issue is here. Like, it's very difficult to get her hands on those handlebars. And with her tail, it sort of pulls her back, which makes it a little bit more difficult even still. So posing her really sort of, I had to rely on leaning her up against something or whatever to get the shots that I wanted. The pegs aren't that helpful to that end. But the scooter itself, I think, looks fantastic. I love the color of it. The wheels have rubber tires and they spin. It's got a kickstand, but you can, you know, drive it around. So I really love that. And I love that it has the basket that you can put Monkey Joe and Tippy Toe in. So I thought that was really cute that they can like ride along in her basket. And overall, I feel like the look of this is really, really good. So when I did my pictures the other night, I did them, of course, with Dr. Doom, who in the 2015 run is her first nemesis that she beats, which is an awesome, I wish I had those comics, but is an awesome issue. So I definitely recommend that you guys read that. It's really fun to read and see her sort of kicking his butt. And if you're looking for other things to do with Doreen as far as posing her, one of her main idols and one of her most endearing qualities is that she is a superhero fan. So her number one superhero is Tony Stark, and she has sort of this extended fantasy of being his sidekick. So she always sort of like moons and like freaks out when she gets to meet other superheroes, which is really fun and really funny. And I do plan to do like a photo set with her and Tony together. She also gets at one point a little crush on Daredevil, and I don't have a Daredevil fig, but if you do, I think that it would be really cute to show her sort of moon-eyed over Daredevil. And she is best friends now with Ms. Marvel, Kamala Khan. So there's a lot of crossover with Squirrel Girl. I was really surprised when I was showing this figure how many people didn't actually know her. So if you don't know her, it's a character worth getting to know, and she crosses over with tons of other characters. Like I said, the Dr. Doom fight is so much fun. I highly recommend you check it out. In my photo set, it might end up a little bit differently, though. You guys are going to have to check that out. But overall, even though there are some sort of logistical issues with this toy as far as being able to stand up with the tail, sitting on the scooter without falling over is a little bit tough. The look of it is so good that if you take the time and effort and get creative with finding ways to make it work, it is well worth it. So once I get her displayed, she might not be one that I take down a lot to play with just because it's gonna be kind of difficult to put her back again, but I know that she's gonna look beautiful on display. So I was really happy with the appearance overall of this toy, and I just have so many fun ideas for the scooter too. So I think that this is definitely worth the $40 buy. It's a really good little set. It also came with a fun background that I used for my photos, which is sort of like just like a park setting. And that turned out pretty fun. I'm not a great photographer, guys, so I just sort of had fun with it, but It was a really good pack for $40. So I hope that you guys enjoyed hearing and seeing about Doreen. If you guys have any Doreen stories to share, please do. If you have photographs of this toy that you've taken, please share those. I'm going to upload this video to my YouTube channel today and my last video. And I will also do a photo dump on there of all of the pictures that I've taken of Unbeatable Squirrel Girl and Dr. Doom. So thank you guys for checking out my video, my review of this figure. I really loved her. I'm going to be doing a toy haul again really soon, and I have a kind of a good karma story to tell about toy hunting. So keep your eyes peeled for my alerts. Make sure you guys are subscribed to my YouTube channel, and I will be back with another video soon. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.